Hello children, a very good morning to you all. Children, in our previous classes till now we have learned addition of 4-digit numbers with carrying and without carrying, and we have also learned the properties of addition like order property of addition, grouping property of addition and the zero property of addition. Now let us move to our next topic, which is solving the word problems or statement problems. So today we are going to learn about word problems. See, by the name itself, you can understand that instead of giving only numbers, some sentences or statements will be given along with the numbers. You have to understand the given data and then solve the problem to get the answer. See, here you all may think that solving word problem is very tough and it is very difficult to write the statements. But actually children, it is very simple. All you need to do is you have to understand the question properly. For that you have to read the given question 2 times or 3 times till you understood, and then so calculate your answer. First of all, you need, see now, let us learn the step by step procedure to solve the word problems. Further, let us take one example. Now, let us write one sum. Meena bought, Meena bought a computer for ₹7546. What is 7546? That is meant by 7546. And an iPod for ₹1853. That is 1853. See children, here I wrote some symbol here. What is that? Children, can you tell me what is the symbol? Have you seen the symbol anyway? You will find this symbol on all the currency notes and coins. This is the rupee symbol. We will write this symbol to represent rupee. So this is the symbol of rupee. So that is why I have written the symbol here, rupees. It means rupees. See children, for example, if you will see this note. Here in 10 rupees note, you can find here. See children, rupee 10. Here you see rupee symbol is there on 10 rupees note. Here you see before 10, you have rupee symbol. Did you identify? This symbol you can find in all the currency notes and all the rupees. Okay? This is the unit to measure money. This is the unit for money. In all the notes and all the symbols you will find, you can see this symbol. You just see, ask your parents and see this symbol on the notes and rupees also. Coins also. Okay, ₹1853. How much money? How much money did she spend? Did she spend in all? See children, come on, read the question once. Meena bought a computer for rupees 7,546 and an iPod for rupees 1,853. How much money did she spend in all? Here in word problems, you will find some keywords like altogether, in all, total, sum of, less, and etc. By seeing these words, you can understand that you have to do addition. By seeing these kind of words, you can easily understand that you have to do the addition. So here, if you will see the sum, we'll have see. In all, in all. So by seeing this word, you can easily, clearly understand that you have to do the addition. Okay. See, what is in all means? That is nothing but total. So how you will get the total? By doing the addition. So you have to add the numbers. What you have to add? Here, there are two numbers are given. Right? So let us add these two numbers to get our answer. But before adding, you have to write the proper statements. So now how to write the proper statement? See here, what is the first number? 7,546. This, what is the 7,546? What is this? Meena bought a computer for 7,546. So what is 7,546? It is the rate of computer. It is nothing but the cost of computer. What is 7,546? The cost of computer. So that is our first statement. Let us write as solution. So what is this? Cost of computer. What is the cost of computer, children? Rupees 7,546. What is the cost of computer? Rupees 7,546. Now let us write some more clearly. See, okay. Now what is the next number? 1,853. And what is this 1,853? What information is it giving? See, an iPod for. So what is 1,853? It is the cost of an iPod. So that is our second statement. Come on, write the second statement. Cost of an iPod. What is the cost of an iPod, children? Rupees 1,853. What is the cost of an iPod? Rupees 1,853. Now you have to add these two. But before adding, you have to write the other statement. What is that? Now let us see. We have written two statements for the given two numbers. Now, what is coming to the question part? What is the question part? How much money did she spend in all? Right? That is the question. In that, how much is the questioning word? Is the question word. So, you no need to write, you need not write this questioning word in the statement. So, what is that? Money did she spend in all? Right? So, here we will use the word amount for the word money. Okay? So, what we have to write? Amount did she spend in all? You can write amount did she spend in all, or you can write money did she spend in all. You can write in any ways. There are much so many ways you can write any of the statement, but it must be proper. You have to write the correct statement to the given question. Now let us write amount she spent, amount she spent in all. Now, what you have to do to get in all means total. So, we have to do addition. So, keep the addition symbol and write the place value. Spent in all. Okay. See, come on, write the place values. 1 spends hundreds and thousands. Now, let us add the numbers. When we are adding, should start from the rightmost place. From 1's place, you have to start. Add 1's place numbers. 6 plus 3. Right? Come on, keep 6 in the mind. Take 3 fingers. After 6, 7, 8, 9. So write 9 and 4 plus 5. 4 in the mind and take 5 fingers. After 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 again. Now what are the 100 place digits? 5 and 8. Come on, keep 5 in your mind and take 8 fingers. Come on, after 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So, what did we get here, children? 13. So, what do you have to write in 13? 1's place digit is 3. So, write 3 here and 1 will be carried over. Okay, come on, add this carried over number also. You should not forget it. 7 plus 1. 8 and 8 plus 1 is 9. So 9,399. Children, while doing the word problem, one more important point you have to remember is you have to write the given units, the measuring units, whatever are given, those also you have to write along with your answer. You have to remember that you have to, your final answer must be along with the units which are given first. So here, what are the measuring units are given for the numbers? Rupees, right? So write rupees also here. So what is our answer? Rupees 9,399. 9,399. Children, after getting this, we have to write the final statement also, which is nothing but amount she spent in all is equals to rupees 9,399. That again you have to write it. That final statement will complete your sum. So again you have to write amount she spent in all. Amount she spent in all is equals to, what is the amount we got? What is the total sum? Rupees 9,399. So in this way we have to solve the word problems. Now let us see few more examples of this word problem. See children, let us solve another sum, another word problem. See here, there are 8901 story books. In a library. How many books are there in all? See children, read the question. There are 8901 story books and 4500. See, you have to place comma after first three digits to separate the periods. 4544 subject books in a library. How many books are there in all? So here also we got the word in all. So by seeing this, we have to understand, we have to understood that you have to do addition. Okay. Oh. Now first, what is the information? What is the first number? 8901. What is 8901? 8901 are story books, right? So 8901 represent the number of books. Yes or no? How many books are there? How many story books are there? That number is correct. So 8901 story books. And what is the next number? 4544. What is this 4504? It represent the number of subject books. And where these are actually these books? In library. These all in the library. Now let us write the statements. Solution. Okay. So what is the first number represents? Story books. So as these are books, right? Number of. NO means number. Number of story books. You can write in a library also. Number of story books in a library. Because we will find these many books, thousands of books in a library only. Yes? We will not have these the thousands of story books in our home or with us, right? So right, number of story books in a library. How many story books, children? 8,901. This is our first statement. What is the second statement? Second statement is about for subject books. right? So write it, number of subject verbs in a library. Number of subject books in a library. How many subject books, children? 4,544. So write that 4,544. What is the next statement? See, coming to the question part. How many books are there in all? Right? So what you have to write? In all means total. So write it as total number of books. Okay. So write total number of books. What you have to do? To get the total number of books, what you have to do? You have to add these two numbers. So you have to add these two numbers. So before adding, you have to keep one symbol here. What is that? As we are adding, you have to keep the addition sign or addition symbol. Children, what is the addition symbol? It is nothing but plus. One horizontal line, one vertical line. Plus. So this is the symbol of plus. You all know this. And write the place values at the top. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Okay? Now, add these two. Come on. Ones place numbers. One, four. So one plus four is five. And zero plus four. Children, in zero property of addition, we have learned that zero, if we add zero to any number, what is the answer? Number itself. You have five pens and you have added zero pens to that. Zero pens in the sense you did not add anything. Right, then how many you will have? Five only. Yes? So, zero plus four. Zero, if you add to any number, you will get the same number. So what? Same number, non-zero number, right? So what is a non-zero number? 0 plus 4 is 4. Right, 4. 9 plus 5. Come on, keep 9 in the mind. Take 5 fingers. After 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. In 14, what is the ones place digit? 4. So write 4 here and 1 will be carried over to the next place, that is thousands place. Don't forget to add the carried over number. If you forget to add the carried over number, your answer goes wrong. So first add the carried over number to the number 8. So 8 plus 1 is 9 and 9 plus 4. What is 9 plus 4, children? Keep 9 in the mind and take 4 fingers. After 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. There is nothing to carry over, no other number, so we have to write 13 here itself. So 13,445. And children, we have learned that you have to write the units. In the previous units are given, that is rupees. But here, no units, right? So this is the normal number, so no need to write anything. But you have to write the final statement. What is the final statement, children? Total number of books where there are in library, right? So write the same thing. Total number of books in a library. What is the sum we got here? 13,445. So that is your final answer. 13,445. So total number of books in a library is equals to 13,445. So children, do you understand? Let us meet our next class. Again, in our next class, we will do some more examples, okay, of this word problems. Okay, children, until then, have a nice day. Bye.